Oh, you heard me listening to an F Plus podcast because I forgot that I started streaming. Oh, I'm back, just tweeting out like, "Hey, you should probably come watch this. Shit's getting real." Yeah, there we go. Cool. Now we have to build back up the viewers, but we're good. So we just finished a chapter of Rule of Rose called The Gingerbread House, where we got some history, maybe? And that's Josh. You should go back and hang with Amanda where you belong. Rag Princess Sews. That's Amanda. She was sewing before. That was cute. Little cat got ripped through the sewing machine. Yeah, sorry it took a little bit longer to get back. I was on the phone with my mom. As you do. Oh, this is an emergency. Joshua the Bear is missing. Search teams are on the lookout. The person who finds him will receive a red crayon and will be invited to join the Aristocrat Club. Red Crayon Aristocrats. Ah, here comes Brown. What up?
Okay.
Hey, boy. Oh, puppy hugs.
Come.
Where would I go? Maybe. A thief will be punished. And there is no Bucket Knight there anymore. Well, let's go down to see where Amanda was. She's somebody who has motive. Hey there, Atomic Ninja. Welcome back. And Belmont says they're going to become a Patreon subscriber soon. I appreciate it. Thank you. Who are you? Would something steal? Why would somebody steal something so precious to the princess? There's Greg. I'm sure Joshua will like the story I wrote for him. Huh. It's a new story. That's in front of Amanda's place. Rag Princess. Once upon a time, there was a girl who sewed rags day in, day out. The stench of the rags seeped into her clothes. Her stepsisters wore beautiful dresses and went to the ball. The girl stayed at home and her jealousy festered. One day, a fairy godmother came, cast a spell on the girl, and said, "Sew yourself an ash gray dress, and then you can go to the ball like your stepsisters." Hey, I'm wearing a gray dress. The girl patched together the sooty rags, and that's how she became the Rag Princess. A very stinky princess indeed. She stunk up the whole town, in fact. No girl who stunk would be allowed into the ball. I'll make that girl wear this awful dress myself, and thus the rag princess and the girl in the rag dress, huh, became play pals. I thought that they were the same person. Weird. Let's see here. Let's go in, see if Amanda's here. People are saying that the Patreon is where the cool kids are. I would say the kids who are here are pretty cool too. Is that mouth breathing? Now if she turns around and she has a weird face, I'm gonna be pretty upset. She is still sad that I gave her the rat stick. Maybe Brown can smell the storybook that I got. Rag's Diary, nothing. Rag Princess, nothing. All legs, nothing. Well, she's asking me if I suspect her of stealing it, and I said that she had motive. So, I know who really took Joshua the Bear. It's, Wendy. She's always sick in bed. It's got to be her. She says, unconvincingly. Huh. I forget. Where is Wendy? Which one is Wendy? Rubbing his belly. Huh, they want a stick. Giving me anything to go on, and they're also turning me around. Look at this. See that? See how it turned me around? You're stopping me from going into, like, the patently wrong areas. Although, that seems to be not right. going to stay on the same floor if I can. This is the engine maintenance. I really don't want to go down here. She told me to go find Wendy. I think she might be up in the first class guest sector where I came from. Maybe that'll help. That's a creepy shadow, even though I know it's mine. No, wrong way. These opening sections of a chapter are always a little bit frustrating because they move very slow until you find your first lead. This is where I admit that I forget who Wendy is. Open the door, you are greeted with a wonderful scent. Yes, it was the fresh scent of the first snow of winter. This is weird. Is that significant? This is my save room here in the dressing room. It's weird, it's like a Hollywood dressing room. Oh, a Hollywood dressing room. Like for the picture shows, you say? Yes. I suck. Talkies are going gangbusters these days. Eh. It's weird. It's a secret door I never noticed before. I wish I could more easily examine what these rooms are. But it's nice that I'm actually able to go into them. Let's see, is it you? Is it the wise princess? Kind of creepy that there's no music and it's just the airship creaking and moaning. Again, more stuff is bound in rope. Weird. Creepy. Came to me just a minute ago and they accused me of saying that I'm the one who took Joshua the bear. How could they think that? I guess I helped her back into bed. She promised to take care of him. That's weird. Are those pictures of the animals? Drawing of a large fish. It's a cute drawing. I guess she crossed out Peter. I didn't mean to go out. Okay, that didn't leave me anything, so maybe I'll go back to Amanda. No, wrong. Wait, is there another secret door here? No, there's not, but I'm glad I found that. Wendy seems too sick and involved to have taken it. Oh. Oh well. Hurry up and go find him, but I need a lead, for fuck's sake. There's something I can get to because Amanda's gone. Hey, Pimp Lobster's here. What up? Still nothing. Still locked. Just had something I could just show Brown. Get me out of this guesswork. Hell, oh, wait. It's her sewing kit. There's something on the floor. Ah, the bear's tail. There we go. The hunt is on. And it smells like Amanda. Cool. Right. Go, boy. Get her. Pimp Lobster has been laying drywall. That is fun. I love using a nail gun. Makes me feel like I'm playing Quake. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, Amanda's up to no good. The hunt is on. She tripped out the power. To restore power after a failure, restart generator 1 in sector 11. Oh, it is so far back. Fuck me. Okay, the generator room. Yeah, now that it's dark, there's probably gonna be some enemies. Come. God, I wish I had a flashlight. Are people reading ahead? They're telling me to equip a weapon. Wow, the colors are different. Sector 11, let's get this party started, by which I mean a generator. Oh. Fuck me. That means there's combat. Pigmen. Pig imps. Oh God. That is a charge, isn't it? I'm going to avoid that. Jesus, do I have to fight it? She's holding her arms out like it's an airplane. So I'm supposed to intuit that the door is now unlocked. Pig Zombie Chocobo. Pigmen is Nintendo's best IP. This is gonna suck. Fuck. There's so many pigmen. If I have to kill all of these things, I'm gonna be so fucking upset. Relief. Someone in the chat, I think it was either Belmont or Zombies, said, God damn it, Amanda, you woke up the combat. Which is right, that is what she did. Snatched off. Generator 2 is operating smoothly. so that kid, in his search for a better fighting stick, sunk the airship and woke the pigmen. Pimp Lobster says, if only there was a machine to take care of all of these pigs. Making a Akonji says, making a real dark descent to the generator room. Why is everything wrapped up in rope? So much combat, dear God. All right, I tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna look at a fact, because I'll be fucked if I'm going to just like die in one of these combat encounters. I want to know exactly where this piece of shit is. Sorry, I don't mean to break the illusion. I don't want to deal with this. Okay. Atomic Ninja 101 says, I hope this fact just says, Pigman everywhere, please send help. Oh, Jesus. Maybe there was something else in that room that he was in. I can't think of Pigmen either without thinking about Seinfeld or without thinking about the Tommy Wiseau sketch on the old Tim and Eric show. Okay. So this kid is dropping biscuits behind him. That's not a euphemism. It's not like he's shitting everywhere. Oh, yeah! Save point! Rock on! Abandon hope? That's not helpful, says Pimp Lobster. Alright, let's see what our friend Brown says. Actually, you know what? The fact says don't use the biscuit to follow Brown, because he will lead you into a combat area. Okay. You need to go to the smoking room, or the room that's adjacent to the smoking room. This is some obtuse-ass shit. Where's the smoking room at? Oh, it's right next door. Oh, that's where all those pigs are. God damn it. Alright, I'm just gonna charge. I just saved. I'm straight up lost, so combat be damned. I'm going to see if he can find my, Brown, lead me into combat where I'm going to die. Brown, do it. Come on, Brown. Good boy. Good boy. Who's a dead boy? Who's a dead boy? You are. You are. Yes, you are. Atomic Ninjas, do you think this... do you think this orchestra is getting tired yet? I know I am. This whole side of the room is cut off. Ugh, fuck me. Is there another way in here? This doesn't show me the doors. Maybe if I go out and around? Yeah, I guess there's another door. Fuck. Okay, out and left. Down I go. If I get up and I'm limping, this is gonna suck. Okay. So you go to the other side of the pantry. Charge. Charge me, motherfucker. Thank you. graceful. Ha ha! Can I use that lever as a weapon to beat the shit out of these pig kids? Bad. Where'd you go, buddy? Shit. I'm glad I turned the brightness up a couple of sessions ago. Jesus. I'm betting that turning these lights back on will not get rid of the pigmen. Things are progressively being wrapped in more and more rope. That is creepy. I'm going to go through here and save again, because fuck ever doing that again. With the small-hearted princess. Just in case, I'm gonna send him back on the trail.
Go!
I can't tell you how worried I was that the dog mechanics in this were gonna be a real drag. But I think overall, it is a huge boon. Oh wow, the pigmen are gone. Neat. Sure looks like a kitchen run by children. Zombie Chocobo rightfully calls out the absurdity of the phrase dog mechanics.
Ah!
Weird. They must want me on a different side of that room. Is there another way into that? Ooh! Now the party starts. Which one of you motherfuckers didn't tell me there was a room full of wine? Which one of you dead-ass motherfuckers? Maybe this will be a place I can go. Now back in the pantry. Wait, did that seriously let me go to a place that otherwise...
No! Come!
This is a fucking drag. What haven't I done yet? It's gonna be wine storage. Okay, I'm gonna look at a fact again because I am out of ideas. Okay, Sector 7 cargo bay. I'm heading toward the wrong side of the ship, but that is where Brown is leading me. God damn it. Oh, and also the camera angle changed and sent me back the wrong way. Why do you have the mechanic if it's gonna be, like, wrong? I'm really frustrated, guys. Why would he lead me in the wrong direction. Yeah, sorry I'm not talking. I don't have anything to say that isn't just inarticulate screaming. I saw her go up, so let's go up. Okay, I'm into it again. Pimplov says, wait, she took an elevator in and ended up in a valley? This game sucks. It's a disgrace. So I wonder if I have Brown look for the bear tail again.
Go!
Thank you. Let's follow that kid. Catch that kid! Too bad it's missing its tail. Well then, take care. Oh no, this is gonna be combat. Are they seriously hemming me into a combat arena? Jesus. How's my health doing? That's not too bad. At least these guys are not like the special ones that can ruin my health bar. Climb off my dick, for fuck's sake. Don't stomp, it doesn't do anything. God. Chortle my balls, a fucking piece of shit, clown garbage game. I'm stuck on that guy. Get that guy as he gets the fuck up.
Go!
Christ on a bike. I feel like I have a vein throbbing on my forehead. Oh, and Brown led me to a dead end. All right, what's the way around that? Belmont says they need a Xanax after that. I already took mine for today, so I'm out of luck. Ugh. Pimp Lobster asked if I've already fought the Drinky Birds, saying that is a cool design. Yes, I fought the Drinky Birds. I agree that it is a cool design. However, they do way too much damage, and there are far too many of them in the room where you have to run around them.
Go!
Oh, there's the kid. Oh, again? For fuck's sake. This is inexcusable. Inexcusable. And now they have weapons, and now I'm dead. There's no excuse for this. There really isn't. Do I have anything that I can eat? Anything at all? Give me anything. Oh, fuck. I'm dead. Okay, we're gonna try this again. I'm gonna take a quick drink here. One moment. Maybe I can find some more healing items. Oh, but if I search for this healing item, then... Nothing. Okay, let's go to the left. There's something in the pantry or in the kitchen. No point being upset. Yeah, I'm gonna check the kitchen and the pantry again, and just see if maybe there's something that that I can be led to. I just need something to give me health. That's really it. And those two, the half biscuits or whatever, those are not actually food. All right. Yeah, forgive me for making, I'm not making you watch this, but forgive me for not being better at this. I wish I was not bad. Yeah, there's nothing here to pick up. Okay. Well, let's go back up to the front of the ship and hopefully it works out better this time. Usually it's really generous with healing items around the time they put you into a meat grinder like that. Maybe I'm just rushing too much. Oh, tell me that as a healing item. Okay, a scone. Not great, but it gives me something. Go. Now it's gonna be a clothespin. Fuck me. Clothespin will lead me to some healing items. It's got candy on it.
Go!
Not gonna lie, I'm real discouraged right now. Scones, but I can probably get something off of this clothespin.
Go.
Marble. Cool. More garbage.
Go.
Candy. That's something. Zombie Chocobo says that there are items in this game called the Stick of Truth, it appears. Oh, and a Master Sword, and also Master Tuna. I like the idea of Master Tuna as a Master Shake-like character who has the same voice, but he's a fish. Okay, a lot of marbles up in here. Surprised somebody hasn't tripped in a hilarious Home Alone-esque fashion.
Go.
I wish I could figure out what all these junk items are for. Stick of Justice. Sorry, I you know, Stick of Truth is the South Park game. I know that. But I'm also reading these chats out of the corner of my eye. Climb off my dick, man. I'm just kidding. It's cool. That was just a funny thing to say right there. Okay, obviously this is just leading me to children's toys. Babytown Frolics. Let's find off of this candy.
Go!
Belmont says, donating 8 clothespins to the gift box will get me a shortbread. Oh God, that is not worth it one whit.
Go!
Okay, at least that's some healing items. I'm kind of done looking for them. Marble.
Go!
Yeah, this game is leaning really, really heavily on some very rickety systems.
Go.
You know what? I don't care. Come. Let's just go. Let's figure this out. Oh, yeah. Zombie Chocobo says don't forget to save. Maybe the filth room still has its bucket night? Maybe? Pimp Lobster asks, Cole, you're unstuck in time. Have you ever played marbles? Yes, I have. Oh, gosh. I have played marbles for keepsies, even. I didn't realize that was an old-timey thing. Yeah, all right, give me a bucket night. Come on, buddy. Come on, buddy. There we are. To be fair, I played marbles in the context of Pogs, so turning it into a thing only 90s kids know. No, I had an inventory full. Hopefully that's a healing item. That'd be nice. No, it's kind of like, hey, I really like the idea of doing something vaguely skill-based. Greg's diary can go away. And, you know, I like having a lot of small objects. Oh, lollipop, that's good. Maybe I have some healing items stored away in my item box for some reason. No food. Fuck me. All right. Hey, not so trusty patches. Here to push me down a hole? Haha, I'm sure you get that a lot. Welcome to the Rule of Rose Frustration cast. Atomic Ninja says, you were pushed down a hole the moment that you press start game. I don't want to believe that. Like, I want to go into this understanding that there are parts of it that are garbage, but there are parts of it that are really inspired and creepy and effective horror that tries and, you know, mostly succeeds at doing stuff I haven't seen, you know, in the context of a video game. Like, there's so much to recommend this, but so much to say, stay away, just watch a video, read the story, read a synopsis. Christ on a bike. You know what? I normally skip the cutscenes we've already seen, but like, I don't know. I feel like we need to see something cool about this game, and that was a pretty cool cutscene. And also, I don't think I can skip cutscenes. Sorry, I should have clarified that. That's a really good question. Does Jennifer ever talk? I don't think she does, actually. This is a silent protagonist situation. All she ever does is, like, cower and faint. It's very, very off-putting. Oakenfork has been looking at the game facts boards, and apparently somebody has done a fists only run. I can't imagine. That makes me so sad. Oh, I missed a, you know, okay, so boo for me, because I missed that there was a bucket knight here. At least I'm happy it's still here, and I have some healing items. Oh, wait, I don't know if he's looking for the right thing. Find. Yeah. Wait, no. Wrong thing. The other vaguely circular.
Go!
Huh. Oakenfork has found some GameFAQs gold. Apparently, this person who ran the who did the fists only run thinks the bad hit detection was an intentional thing to invoke strategy, or I don't even know. They say it's Stockholm syndrome. That is bleak, is what it is. As is this bullshit right here. At least these ones don't immediately kill you because they have weapons. Why do they drop into the room like they're fucking Iron Man? They're trying to nurse off of my armpit. Come on. Just register, please. Register a goddamn hit for once in your life. Bork, 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 bork. My son is also named Bork. Bork, 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 bork.
Go!
Oh wait, shit. You know what I'm gonna do? Zombie Chocobo recommended I go back and save. That's what I'm gonna do. Is that the lift? Yeah, I suppose it is. Ugh. I hate being lost. This game is gonna give me conniptions. Gotta say, alcohol's helping. Thank you. There's a chapter in House of Leaves where one of the narrators, one of the main characters, describes a nightmare of kind of wandering through the belly of kind of this rusted out hulk of a ship. And it's kind of like a labyrinth, and they're, you know, stuck in this maze as the ship is sinking around them. And it feels like this. I mean, mazes are always going to be a little bit scary. I'm just trying to find the positive, and usually looking for a House of Leaves comparison is a good way to do that.
Go!
What if I don't go to that junction? This is probably a broken walkway, but... He mentioned House of Leaves. Drink, says Zombie Chocobo. You know, you gotta fall back on patterns sometime, you know? Alright, this is gonna suck. House of Roses, like The Bachelorette, Atomic Ninja and Pimp Lobster say. I've never seen a single episode of The Bachelor or The Bachelorette, but I'm addicted to Rose Buddies. That is a good podcast. Yeah, you can't avoid this shit. I'm gonna see if I can, like, herd them into a place. Oh, there's more of them. There are four this time. Fucking garbage is what this is. No, don't stomp! Don't stomp! No. Fuck me. Stomp. You know it does nothing. Makes you feel good, but it doesn't do anything. Stop it. It's like praying. Jesus Christ. If they throw a third one at me, I'm gonna go back and save. All right, which direction am I facing? Sector 6 lift, is that where I'm supposed to go? I forget which lift I'm... Yeah, definitely not Sector 13. Yeah, sorry about that religious jab that I have there. I thought it'd be funny, but it just turns out that I'm mean. Yeah, I'll be fucked if I'm gonna do any of that again. Well, wait a minute. So in the chat, they're talking about the soundtrack being like a string quartet. Zombie Chocobo says they're the string quartet version of the Jizz Whalers from Star Wars. Is that a thing? Is there a thing in Star Wars called? Let me just say what you said there. The Jizz Whalers. Because that is really important information that I need to know as soon as possible. The Cantina Band is called the Jizz Whalers? Is jizz the type of music? Did George Lucas try to say jazz but say jizz? And say, no, I meant that. I meant it to be that way. They don't understand what semen is here. It's space semen.
Go!
You're fucking kidding me. They're saying jizz is the style of music. Oh, that is one of the best facts I've ever heard. You're kidding me. Sorry, you guys broke me. You broke me with that shit.
Come round.
Hogan Fork says that the jizz instruments include the clap beepbox. Beepbox! You're fucking kidding me.
Go!
Yeah, I like a Star War. I'll go see a Star War. I saw a lot of Star Wars movies when I was real young. I have some affection for the franchise, but that is the dumbest goddamn thing I've ever heard. Pimplop lobster? No. Why did you just say, man, I wish I was sounding some plume right now? I don't understand the world anymore. Apparently it's always been that way, but I thought I had it, but I don't. Not anymore. You guys have unseated something foundational from inside me. I don't know if it's because Rule of Rose broke me. I don't know if it's... One second. Oh, you fuckers. I'm going to this lift. Every one of these intersections, not every one, but most of them, have been... Oh, fuck you! Oh, and the pig ones. You mix in pig ones? This is funny, guys. This is great. I'm having a good time. Everything is wonderful. We live in the best of all possible worlds, and it's root beer, whiskey, and sunshine. Love it. Just bask. Feel that. Quitting isn't an option. No. No, I'm Clark. I'm Clark Griswold on Christmas. We're gonna have the hap-hap happiest Rule of Rose since Bing Crosby tap dance with Danny fucking Gay. Okay.
Go.
Not-so-trusty Patches in the chat asks if we do Dreamcast for Abject Suffering now. Dreamcast is still kind of tough to emulate, at least in our experience so far. We've done Ill Bleed. We've done, like, kind of a handful of others, I think, maybe. It's hard to remember, honestly. It really just depends. Suggest everything, honestly. Like, go and, you know... fill that in. If we can't emulate it, it just won't end up on the show. Or we, you know, sideline it until we can figure out how to do it. But yeah, we did Ill Bleed. And also, I'm just straight up running in the wrong direction. Ugh. Thank you. Yeah, I like the old bleed episode of Abject Suffering a lot. And also, I like Illbleed. I like the idea. I didn't get very far in it. Because, you know, we only have so much time to play them. And also, it's kind of a hard game to figure out. But I'm excited to do more of it. No, that's wrong, I think. You're going the wrong way, dog. No, you're going the right way. Seems to go up. Up and over. Thank you, Zombie Chocobo, for encouraging me to save. God, she's hugging me. And I'm dead. Alright. So I wasn't mobile enough. It's 12:30. I've got one more run at these things in me, before my head explodes. Yeah. Okay. So Zombie Chocobo is recommending I use the meat cleaver. I'm going to go to this FAQ and see if they have any stats about these weapons. Because I've been just kind of operating on feel more than anything. Oh, there's nothing. Yeah, only one entry for meat cleaver. Fuck. Let me try the other one. I want to arm myself with information. Okay, yeah, it's they do comparable damage. All right. I also wish this wasn't just a goddamn marathon. For the record, you guys are hearing me at just about the angriest I've been with a game. This is superfluous. This is combat for the sake of combat in such an artificially hostile way that doesn't contribute anything to the themes, construction, plot, mood, atmosphere of this game that I really, really want to like. I really want to like this game so much. And the fact that they're just saying, hey, in this probably pretty important section of the game, we're going to make it as hard as possible for you to proceed, that is unforgivable. We're going to lean into the the most half-baked system of this piece of garbage. It's It's less than nothing. It's less than nothing. It's taking away.
And everyone lived happily ever after.
All right, I'm going to go to bed. There is no more to be gained from this. I'm probably not going to stream until I get past this. When that happens, you'll get the alert and everything. But yeah, I don't see anything else to be gained from anybody watching me beat my head against that section. I still want to see the rest of this game. Yeah. So, cool. Watch the archived playthroughs if you missed any. Xcrank.com. Also, youtube.com/duckfeedtv. Thanks, everybody, for watching. Sorry I flew off the handle. This is just too much. Can't deal with it now. Yeah, hope you have a great night, and enjoy your Sunday. All right. Later, everybody. Bye.